Wow. Daina, you look very handsome tonight.
Thank you so much. Shikan, are you playing that music?
I am.
I need to offer some
time. Ella, you're back from Michigan, huh?
No, she's
I'm back up in Michigan. Ran some errands in Oak Park and made the fast turnaround. We've got one more week till our boat comes off the lake, so we're enjoying this weather.
Oh, good. It was a pretty day today, too.
Yeah, it really was.
Hi, Yukiko. You look very beautiful.
Hi, how are you?
Flower on your ear. Yes.
Chris.
Betty Jane.
Oh, just in time.
And there's Chris, Lucelle. Nice to see you, Chris. Oh, they're the twins, Beth and Lisa. Hula twins.
We're under Felix.
Hi.
Okay, can you put it on the...
That sounds like Liz. She has come back from all her deliveries.
Okay, I'm going to put the...
Baskets.
Here.
There's Felix.
Hello.
Hi, Felix. Hi, Liz.
Hi, Sensei. Hey, Roshi.
Hi.
Oh, look, it's Risha. Risha from Big Volcano. Right,
yay.
Volcano, yay, you made it. And there's Nick in the background, all right.
Oh, fun.
In their beautiful home.
Hi, you guys, I haven't seen you for so long.
Yeah.
Many moons.
You opted for the beach instead of the freezing cold rain.
Yeah.
Well, I'm glad you joined us.
Just squeaked in.
All right. There's Kathy Bart, right? Kathy Bart, my hula student, also out in Indio, California. All right.
Oh, wow.
Great.
Nice.
And her husband. And Alpita, you joined us. Great to see you, too.
We're going to go.
Robert looks very jazzy.
This is Nancy Strauss. This is Nancy. Hi, Nancy.
And Mary. And Mariette. Aloha.
Aloha. Aloha. Nancy is the grandmother of one of my hula students in Niles, Michigan, right? Wow. Thanks for joining us.
And Mariette is the aunt. That's Katie's sister.
Oh, of course. Hi, Marianne. You look like Katie.
Aloha.
I'm taking a picture of the screenshot, so please have a smile.
Oh, okay.
Smile. Thank you.
So, Robert, you want to get us going?
Let's see how we're doing. Maybe another minute or so, huh? Or what?
Just let me know.
Up to you. Let's see how we're doing.
Yeah.
We're at 45.
Yes. Tell me when to fire.
Or maybe we're going to break into groups, right, first?
ECMC.
I need
that a little bit.
Jean, Mr.
Lost the voice there.
Sky's joined us too. Oh, Mark Templeton.
Hey, Mark.
Great. Nice to see you. Hi. And hi, Sky.
Hi, Sky.
And Lauren Herrmann. Nice to see you, Lauren. And Tanya is here too. Very nice to see you, Tanya. Oh, and the twins and Lynn, your mom and your dad, Merle, is here too. Fabulous. Great to see you. Yay. Jason, brother,
Jason.
You made it.
Oh, nice.
From where are you in Pennsylvania?
Bethlehem.
Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. Oh, we're all over. That's so fabulous. Nice. Well, I guess we can just sit, huh? That's always a good thing. We're good at that.
I screened before and I told how many people were joining this.
At least 30, I bet.
Right, I saw Patty also here, Patty Morse. Great to see you.
She's in Chicago.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I think we'll probably get started, Robert. What do you think? Our wonderful MC, I'm going to introduce him, looking very handsome in his tuxedo, all from Milwaukee.
As you could make it.
Robert Schwoch. Here we go.
Who's that from?
Peter.
Good guy.
Okay. On behalf of the Zen Life Meditation Center of Chicago, welcome to our gala benefit. Celebrating the 10th anniversary of ZLMC. Obviously, we wish everybody could be together in person tonight, but the virtual celebration has some advantages. We can have a guest list that sort of transcends geographic boundaries. I'm already seeing we've got people from all over North America, really. And also, the Zoom format is gonna also allow us to do some pretty cool things with a multimedia artistic presentations that we think you'll really enjoy. Tonight is actually just the start of a year of celebration that the center is doing. We're gonna celebrate the 10th year all year long. And we're hoping that we can do an in-person celebration at the end of this year, a year from tonight on October 10th, 2021. So cross your fingers. Mm-hmm. Thanks so much to the team at ZLMC that put this together. They've done a great job, and I think it's going to be a really special evening. So before we begin the program, just a few technical things. And some of you may not be that familiar with Zoom. We're going to have a great crowd tonight. We've had 80 RSVPs, so we have a lot of windows. But with that many windows and sound feeds, you might want to mute your sound, if you're not actually talking. You can find a mute and unmute button at the lower left of your Zoom window. If you're not familiar with Zoom, at the upper right of your main window, you can switch between speaker view and gallery view. So speaker view spotlights whoever's speaking or whatever's going on, you know, whatever's been spotlighted at the time. Gallery view fills the screen with tiles of all the people that you can switch from screen to screen and see everybody. And all those windows are equal sized for each attendee. Tonight's program, you're probably best watched most of it in speaker view. Although there will be a couple of dance numbers later, where we will prompt you, we'll encourage you to go over to gallery view, which we'll encourage you at that time also to turn off your video, mute your video, which will bring the dancers' windows together on your screen. Finally, if you note at the bottom of your screen is also a chat button, and you're welcome and encouraged to use the chat box and use the chat function to just interact with everybody as the proceedings go along. Don't feel bashful about putting things in the chat. I'll just put something, you know, I'll just put a welcome in the chat just so you can see how it works. So hopefully, speaking of welcome, hopefully you've received your gift bag either by mail or in person. The gift bag, if you were in Chicago, if you contained some Prosecco, if it was mailed, there's something non-alcoholic in their San Pellegrino water. It's not legal to send alcohol across state lines, of course. So we couldn't do that by mail. Anyway, you may wish to have the Prosecco or the San Pellegrino or your favorite toasting beverage on hand. I'm not fooling around. I'm already, my precepts got postponed on because of the pandemic. So I'm getting my shots in when I can. The gifts also, the gift box, you should also have found a bell that you can ring. Now at toast time, you can unmute and ring your bell, or you could just hold the bell up to the camera and show us that you're ringing it to celebrate the toasts. You should also find in your gift bag some handmade. Handmade masks from the Zen Care team. The Zen Care team at the Zen Center has been sending masks, COVID masks, to groups of people who maybe are not able or to get their hands on those masks so easily. There's a cookie made from scratch by BB's Bakery in Oak Park. Some festive chocolates should have been in there. And a couple of posters designed by our own Christian Solorzano, who you'll meet later.
Hey, Robert.
Hey, Robert. Hey, June.
Hey, Gwen. Hi, Gwen.
Patrick, Jackie.
Cheers.
Roshi.
Yep. Yeah, cheers.
Cheers.
Mama, you're so cute.
Interesting feature. 49 people.
Oh, we're coming up 51.
Hi, Jason.
Wait for everybody to get back in from their breakout.
Nice to see you.
We're back.
Yeah.
Oh, Eve is here. Eve Marco.
Oh. Here. Hi, Eve.
Hi. Oh, hi, Eve. Hey there.
Hi.
Hi, everyone. It's great to be here.
Hello. Melanie, and there's Katie. Hi, Katie. Wow. I saw your mom and your sister, Katie.
I'm excited.
Okay, I think we're just about all back. So,
say hi.
Now, to sort of officially start the festivities, we're going to have a tradition from both the Hawaiian and Buddhist traditions, the sounding of the conch shell. The sounding of the conch in Hawaii, it's a traditional celebration. It started by sounding the conch in four directions. In Vajrayana Buddhism, it's also a tradition to sound the conch to harmonize energy. So let's take a few minutes to listen to the sound of the conch. For that
powerful,
beautiful opening blessing chant, Sensei. Next, we have a special treat. We have a dance film entitled Mantras in Movement. This is by Lauren Herrmann, who's, I think she's with us tonight. Lauren, could you give a wave?
Hi, everyone.
There. Hi. I saw the film. It's spectacular. Lauren is currently a professional dancer with the Chicago Repertory Ballet, which is a contemporary ballet company in town. She has performed in soloist and ensemble roles and has worked with Chicago choreographers Taylor Mitchell, Mariana Oliveira, Wade Schaaf, Shannon Alvis. She began her professional career in her hometown of Portland as a dancer in Portland Opera's La Traviata before she relocated to Chicago and continued her artistic pursuits. She's performed with the Conservatory Dance Company and trained alongside companies such as Hubbard Street Dance Chicago, Northwest Dance Project, and the Pittsburgh Ballet Theater. Now, ladies and gentlemen, please enjoy Lauren Herrmann and Mantras in Movement.
Before we start, Robert, can we ask everyone to mute themselves?
That would be the sound. Yeah, if you could just, the mute button, as I mentioned, in the lower left, if you could just. Really, really beautiful. Thank you. Yeah. Very, very beautiful. Thank you. I'd like to turn the festivities over now to the Zen Center's board president for the past 2 years, Robert Dharmacloud Demery. Robert started his practice of meditation and study of Buddhism in 1980 at the New York Dharma Datu Meditation Center. He's been coaching, teaching, and facilitating individuals and teams for more than 25 years, during which he founded Next Step Leadership, an executive coaching firm dedicated to developing leaders. He's certainly been a great leader for us at ZLMC. So Robert, take it away.
You need to unmute.
There we go. All right, thank you, Kelly, for
sure.
The challenges of Zoom. Anyway, thank you so much. That was, I feel a little humbled from following from that beautiful dance. But on behalf of the board of directors, it's with my great joy and gratitude to welcome you all to this, to our 10th anniversary gala benefit. We really hope you have a grand evening of celebration of the 10 years of ZLMC's steadfast commitment and service to our mission. And when I got the poster, I'm sure hopefully all of you've gotten the poster, and the mission is to live in an awakened world that transforms suffering into compassion and delusion into wisdom. I don't think I need to say anything else beyond that, but that's what we're all about. That's what the center is all about. And now I'd like to introduce our new executive director, Michael Shikan Brunner, who just started in his new position on October 1st. Michael, take it away.
Good evening, everyone. I'm happy to be here with you this evening. Thanks so much for making this evening special. You know, it was a little over 10 years ago I first walked through the doors of ZLMC. It was a different place then, but I had the same heart. And I came tired and stressed and looking for answers. And I found a lot more than that. I found a home. And I found a family in all of you. And I want to thank you for making the Zen Life and Meditation Center such an extraordinary place to practice, so special. And I'm grateful now that 10 years on, I've had the ability to kind of dedicate my life and myself to the service of the Sangha as your new executive director. I'm so thankful for the Zen Life and Meditation Center, and especially for the efforts of Roshi and Sensei in cultivating such a special place over the last 10 years. So I look forward to celebrating with all of you tonight. I look forward to the 10 years that has been, and I look forward to the 10 years in the future and what we're gonna build over that time frame. So a toast to where we've been and where we're headed.
Cheers.
Thank you, Michael. So now it's my pleasure to introduce a wonderful segment of our program, and I want to introduce Jason Poole, my dear friend that I met in New York City a long time ago. He's a very special man. He is a kumuhula, kumuhawai, I'm sorry, a master of the Hawaiian traditions. And he is also a fabulous singer, a poet, a writer, and he's come to our halau, our hula school, to teach and to sing for us when we dance. That is a very special thing. So Jason, Brada, are you here? Brada is like brother, you know, Brada is the pigeon. English. Brada, are you here, Brada?
I'm here. So, What am I introducing exactly? The song.
The song, I Am What I Am.
Oh, I'm so happy to share. So June asked me, Sensei asked me to look at a song that was written by a Hawaiian musician and master teacher of the ukulele and a master musician named Roy Sakuma. And Uncle Roy wrote this song back in 1970, I believe. And the beauty of Hawaiian music is that it's music of the heart. It's not necessarily very complicated music in terms of number of chords or fancy playing, but it is very complicated in that it really tells the story of the heart. It sounds very simple, just a couple chords and words that don't rhyme, but it's a beautiful, beautiful song called I Am What I Am. And it is being sung and played by her young students, her keiki hula students, who are playing the ukulele and singing, and believe me, singing and strumming at the same time is no easy feat, but they do such a beautiful job. And we were able to do it from Chicago and Pennsylvania and through technology, stitch it all together. So this is Uncle Roy Sakuma's I Am What I Am.
Right, when he was writing the song, Roy, he said he was at a very down time of his life. And he just picked up a ukulele and this song just came out. So it's, I hope you will enjoy it.
One, two, here we go.
Videos, our resident board member and multimedia expert Christian Solorzano has put together a really special video appreciation of the last 10 years of the Zen Center. So let's have a look at that now.
Hi, my name is Kelly and I've been at the Zen Center for a handful of years now. On the special 10-year celebration, I wanted to take a moment to say how grateful I am for our Sangha and for my teachers, Sensei and Roshi. It's difficult for me to think of all the ways that my family and I have benefited from my time at the center, but I do want to say that it does leave me so inspired to share that blessing with others in our greater community. In such confusing and chaotic times, the Zen Center is a shining example of goodness in our world and a true treasure. Congratulations on this great milestone tonight.
One of the things that I love about Zen Life and Meditation Center of Chicago is that very same Sangha. We have friends that we would have never ever met, and these friends are now no longer new friends, they're old friends. And I don't mean old in the sense of age, I mean old, solid friends. And when one is doing something that's exciting, we feel excited for them. And when there are family problems or illness, we feel that and are sad and caring for them as best we can. I want to say that this has been a wonderful opportunity belonging to the Zen Life Meditation Center of Chicago, and I wouldn't give it up for anything.
These days, I appreciate that listening to Roshi and Sensei giving their talks. I enjoy being the facilitator for the Program and Marketing Center Circle. And I appreciate the Shikan's program, the Commit to Sit, especially when I'm confined to the house. So that's very valuable to me. So for my wife, Vivian, and I, we've met a number of friends who are a part of this community, and we're really feeling blessed to have such rich friends, rich experiences here. So it's really been a wonderful time, and I hope to have more years to enjoy in this center. So thank you.
Hi, I'm Vivian Lund. I am so grateful to be a member of this Sangha and to be a witness to its growth, struggles, resiliency, and support during the 8+ years that I've been attending. I am particularly thankful for the sense of safety that I feel in being a part of such a loving and caring Sangha. The freedom to explore and learn about myself and my responsibilities to the world and to its people all around me is deepening my sense of compassion and gratitude. Thank you, Roshi and Sensei, for allowing me to include ritual in honoring the four seasons as a part of our Dharma talks, and also for your support of the Year to Live Circle and all other circles that aim to enrich our lives. Happy anniversary to all of us.
The Zen Center has enriched not only my spiritual life, but my life in general, with the Buddhist classes that Robert and June offer, plus many cultural presentations and events, such as learning more about the true tradition of hula, participating in drawing workshops, listening to social justice speakers, really too many things to try and name. I've also made new friends at the Zen Center. These relationships have become treasured friendships over the 8 years that I've been a member of the Zen Center. So I'm very grateful to June and Robert, and very grateful for the Zen Center, which has become such an important part of my life. Thank you, Robert and June.
I had been looking for a spiritual home for a long time, and I feel that I've really found it at the center. And I'm just very, very happy and grateful that we have found it.
Yes, and I tagged along. And I made a home. The center is really wonderful people. I know I originally joined, I originally wanted to meditate because I thought it would help me with my golf game. And I probably mentioned this a number of times to people because they ask me, how's your golf? So my golf game is worse. Well, not worse, but it's not any better. But I'm actually enjoying it. So I think that's the difference. You know, if you want to be satisfied with your life, you have to find some good people, I think. And that's what I was impressed with. The people at the Zen Center are very... Yeah. They're very friendly, and they're just good people. So, that's it?
That's it.
Is that it?
That's it.
Okay.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Hello. My name is Henry Honolay West. The Zen Life and Meditation Center of Chicago has helped me in a way that I can explain it the best I can. As you can see, I'm living with mental health issues. When I first met Miss June and Robert, they welcomed me into their lindo, and they taught me the methods of mindful meditation. Since then, I learned to live with a clear mind and a healthy outlook. I owe a great deal to them.
The Zen Life and Meditation Center has impacted me in a lot of different ways. First, I got to make a lot of good friends. I got a lot of courage from all the support there. I have a lot of favorite memories, like the retreats, one in Wisconsin with canoes, one on the Big Island of Hawaii, midnight sitting for New Year's with a Japanese breakfast afterwards, and a lot of other really good memories. It's been wonderful. Thank you.
10 years. And the Gomaggio only gets better. So after 10 years, what do I still need to work on? The question at the moment is, why is it so hard to get up and be awake from early morning sittings? This is my mystery, and I have not learned the answer to this one yet. Waking up in the morning is my practical householder's koan. I sometimes see my original face while fighting the alarm clock, and it's not a serene or composed face. It is more hungry ghost or fearsome animal than Buddha. I will keep working on the waking up problem. One of these days, we will all wake up together, and I will be there with you. Even if, and maybe especially if, it's at the crack of dawn. Here's to another 10 years. Thank you, Sensei and Roshi and all my spiritual friends.
Wonderful, thank you. Great testimonials. Sorry about your golf game, Earl. Next, I'd like to turn the evening over to our board vice president, longtime Buddhist practitioner and ordained Zen priest at the center, Diane Bacek. Diane?
Thank you, Robert. And good evening, Zen and Hula friends and family. It's really wonderful to be able to come together like this and to celebrate ZLMC's 10th year anniversary, and particularly to honor two very, very special people that I have such love for in my heart, our teachers and co-founders, Roshi and Sensei. So I'd like to just have us raise our glasses, and as we begin this section of honoring our teachers and showing our gratitude, may all beings find the path to happiness and friendship as we're able to do here at ZLMC. Thank you, Roshi and Sensei. We have so many esteemed guests and who have been longtime friends and Zen practitioners with Roshi and Sensei that will now say a few words regarding their connection and their relationship. So first I'd like to have us welcome Roshi Agokyu, who was the abbot of Zen Center Los Angeles and is currently the abbot emeritus and head teacher there. And Agokyu Roshi is also the co-author with Roshi Myon and Eve Marco of the book, The Book of Householder Koans. And if you haven't read it, this is my plug for the book. It's fantastic. And Roshi, Eve came to do a workshop pre-pandemic, and it was just absolutely wonderful. So is there a movie or a welcome from Agokyu Roshi? Okay, can maybe run that now?
We're working on it.
Oh.
Can you, can we skip to the next sure. question and we'll get that going?
Sure. Now I'd like to introduce Roshi Jikyo Nicolai McMahon, who also happens to be Roshi Joshin's teacher, as well as the Dharma heir of Zen Master Taizen Maizumi Roshi. Jikyo Roshi is the co-founder of the Three Treasures Zen Community in San Diego and has developed the practice of immediacy in the arts that if you've come to a sesshin at the center, we practice that, and it's so rewarding and so rich and artistic and creative, and it really adds a dimension to our sesshin in a way that I never expected. So please, Jikyo Roshi, if you could say a few words.
Yes, I'd be delighted to. I was just reflecting, giving transmission to Joshin in Hawaii. It was the 31st of December, 1998. And his for transmission, you give another name. So it's Joshin Kyosei Althouse. And Kyosei means mirror of truth, which I feel very much fits Joshin Roshi. And then when he gave transmission to June in 2014, I was again so delighted. As you all know, June is a rich, rich human and very heart-centered and so creative. And whenever I'm with Joshin and June, I just enjoy hanging out with them, just being with them for the people they are, for the people you are. And the watching how the Zen Life Meditation Center has grown and ripened and matured, I'm very struck by the generosity, the sense of grace at the center, the depth in the simple things of life. And I remember when Joshin echo. I'm not sure what to do about that. Did it go away? Can you hear me? Yeah, good, okay. I was just reflecting on the when Joshin and June decided to go in the new directions of really developing ways of reaching out to community and making the Zen life more accessible to people. And I thought it was a brilliant idea. And I'm so glad they trusted themselves. And the support of everybody, your Sangha is, the Sangha members are just wonderful. I was trying to remember when I was out there. When was it? About 6-7 years ago? Something like that, yeah. And I so enjoyed all of you. And I'm looking forward to the possibility of being able to get in a plane and go someplace. So that's in the future. I'd love to come see you. And my son and family lives in Asheville, so I could go see them and come see you or reverse, but it would be such a delight. And I'm looking forward to the Dharma talk is about mid-November. And so we'll have gotten through a few things in our current world, and we'll see what emerges to address. But again, beautiful job, and congratulations, and congratulations to all of you. You can have the teachers, but it takes the Sangha working together and being in support of one another and teachers and communities, and you've done a beautiful job. Thank you.
Thank you, Roshi Jikyo. Are we ready, Shikan, or should I go on to the next?
We are ready, I believe. Let's give this a shot.
Okay.
Aloha, June and Joshin, and all of you at the Zen Life and Meditation Center. I'm here in the garden of the Zen Center of Los Angeles, where the two of you were married many years ago by Maizumi Roshi. Since that time, I've watched your vows grow in love, in friendship, in service, and in Dharma. I love how your Dharma paths and vows have commingled. For years, I've seen you listen deeply to what was needing to arise. And now we have this amazing skillful means called the Zen Life and Meditation Center in Chicago. Deep training, devotion, and hula dancing. Congratulations on your 10th anniversary year. May your Dharma live for 10,000 years. Much love.
Thank you, Roshi Igokyu. Now I'd like to also welcome another very, very dear friend of Roshi and Sensei's, Roshi Mion and Eve Marco, who is the head teacher at Green River Zen Center in Massachusetts. And Mion and Roshi also worked in the Zen Peacemaker Order along with her late husband, Roshi Bernie Glassman. And Mion and Roshi is a writer and an editor and a co-author with Igokyu Roshi of the Book of Householder Koans. So Roshi, Eve, can you say a few words, please?
Sure. I want to say a lot of words, actually. This is so fabulous, and I'm so moved that you asked me to say something. I have a lot of memories of June and Joshin. The first one is when Sensei was in Yonkers with Roshi in about 97, and we were beginning to sew roksus and priest robes, kesas, in a pamsula way, which meant that you took different fabrics from your life and things that had been thrown away, dyed them and put them together and sewed them together. And I believe Sensei was the very first, at that point she wasn't ordained, she sewed the very first what we call a Zen Peacemaker Roksu. I think that I was after her, but she was the very first one. And I watched her do that. And that was just the beginning of inspiration from her. And of course, both of them and me and Bernie, of course, worked for a few years with Zen Peacemakers. And we worked in California, and then we convoyed together to New England. And Roshi, of course, then worked on really working, developing the Zen Peacemaker Order. And whether he knows it or not, I'm continuing that work right now. And Sensei was working, bringing organizations together that weren't Buddhist, but were necessarily doing their social action based with a spiritual foundation. And then they went to Chicago. But there's a real line here. And that line is that they were developing new earth forms. We were all trained in a particular Japanese way, but for this country, for the West, and for this globalized world, we need new forms. That was what the Zen Peacemaker Order is about. That's what Sensei worked on. And it is so obvious to me whenever I come to Zen Life Meditation Center that they continue to develop new earth forms right in Chicago, you know, right in Oak Park. There's, you know, I can see it. If you've gone around in different centers, you can see the difference. There's not that many centers that are so open that really, you know, give very important teachings on what is our life, what's right in front of our nose, how to avoid the distractions and consumerism of today, and how to behave with compassion. Regardless of how Zen Buddhist you are, they're reaching that. That's what they're teaching. And you can't take that for granted. I don't think there are that many Zen centers that do that. And that's why I so much love the name of your center, Zen Life and Meditation Center, Zen Life. It's all of life. So that regardless of where you are, you can find yourself there. And that's because they did that. They designed that. It didn't just happen by itself. So I think what you did is so beautiful, Joshin and June. And I just want to add one more thing, because I'm aware that in this is the beginning of a year of raising money and energy for the center. I so appreciate what so many of your members say, starting with Michael, about what it meant to go in the doors the first time and people find a home, people find their needs met, they make friends, and it makes a real impact on their life. And that's how it always starts. But what's really important is to make sure that that goes on for the future and that it goes on for future people, that those new Zen forms continue and evolve with a lot of life, you know, and that they're dynamic and that they go on to the next generation and the next generation. You know, that's really what it's about. At our age, you know, we don't do this work because we need more friends or more support system. We have that already, but we have to think about the next years and the next generations. And you're never too young to think about that. Not given the world we live in right now and the challenges. So I'm so thrilled with Zen Life Meditation Center. I too, like Jikyo, love to visit. It has a very special spirit. And when things are that good, it is so worthwhile investing in and make sure that other people, younger people, you know, find it and treasure it as we do. Thank you. Thank you, Joshin and June.
Thank you, Roshi Myonin. And please, finally, let's welcome one more very dear friend of Roshi and Sensei's, a longtime Zen practitioner, Pam Roque, who is a longtime devoted Sangha member of Zen Center Hawaii during the time that Roshi and Sensei were co-teachers and founders there. So Pam, can you say a few words?
Sure, thank you. I was thinking that we all wouldn't be sitting here tonight if it wasn't for the deep intention that Joshin set over 30 years ago when he said that he wanted to teach and do service work in a large populated area. Because where I met him was a tiny little town up there in Waimea with a very little population. And I went to their house that was, it was a cattle ranch town, and their house was bordered on the cattle pasture and whatever. And he had made a room at the top of the house. And so, I went up to that room up above the house and got instructions on how to sit. I wanted to meditate. I didn't know a thing about meditation. But he had, it was so, he was very structured. He always wore his robe. We, you know, things were, June had to hit the bell on time. And I mean, it was like, you know, toe the mark. Till we got downstairs, then we could kind of lighten up. But I remember when he brought in those papers and he wanted me to be treasurer. He was setting up the Zen Center of Hawaii as a nonprofit organization. And I'll never forget that. It was just like, he was going to do it. And he said, you know, someday I'm going to be able to teach with more people. And June, I remember June sitting on the floor in the living room, sewing her first hula mat. She was so excited about learning hula. And you're right, the person, I think of them as two gems of the three treasures. And I love them both dearly. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Pam. So now we're at the point in the evening that we all have an opportunity, a special opportunity, I should say, to really say thank you from the bottom of our hearts and the bottom of our checkbooks. So thank you again to everybody here. There's been such incredible acts of generosity in our Sangha and our local Sangha, our far-reaching Sangha that's benefited the mission and the work. We were able to purchase the beautiful building and this beautiful center and the precious teachings that arise and are available to everyone happen through the extraordinary gifts of money and service and friendship and volunteering and teaching. So our 10th year anniversary team, along with our generosity and membership circle, have set a goal for this evening to raise $25,000 by the end of the night to express our deep gratitude for the center and for our teachers, Roshi and Sensei. But here's some inspiration. We already have received from an anonymous donor $5,000 towards furthering the mission of ZLMC. Egoku Roshi has gifted $500 towards our goal, and we have another opportunity from another anonymous donor who will match every dollar given tonight up to $10,000. So inspiring that by the very act of giving, we are honoring our teachers, Roshi and Sensei, who have worked tirelessly to bring the Dharma and hula to this beautiful place of refuge in Oak Park. Roshi and Sensei, as you all know and have felt, had incredible hearts of compassion, humor, kindness, gentle, soft, you know, needing to just help everyone in all of our practices. So I would like to encourage us to think deeply about how can we repay their kindness and the kindness of having such a beautiful center in ZLMC and really dedicate our merits of generosity to making our world a better, gentler, kinder place. So if you're able and you wish to make an additional contribution tonight to honor Sensei and Roshi and all the work they've done and the work that remains ahead of us, you'll have a link in the chat box that takes you directly to PayPal, or you can just indicate what you'd like to donate. And as we get those links or we get those donations, you'll hear the bells starting to go off. So in the chat box, if you want to use PayPal, you're certainly welcome to make a donation. You can even ring your own bell and toot your own horn about providing an act of generosity. Nothing is too small or unappreciated. Everything helps us further the mission of providing this beautiful place to practice in Oak Park and throughout the world. So thank you to everyone who's here tonight, who purchased tickets, who might be donating some extra funds. We're hoping to get to 25,000 at the end of the evening. I know this feels like probably a public broadcasting pitch, but it it's such a beautiful act to repay the kindness of Roshi and Sensei, who have been so kind to all of us. So as we've got the, you'll see the link, but I'd like to introduce, although they need no introduction, I would like to introduce Roshi and Sensei, our precious teachers who inspire us, who guide us, who care for us, and through their selfless actions and their deep understanding of Dharma and Hula, and showing the supreme good example of what it means to be a Zen teacher, Zen practitioner, and a human being, a good, good human being. I'd like to turn it over to Roshi and Sensei. Thank you.
Thank you. That was quite wonderful to hear. So I'm very touched, and Roshi is crying over here on the side. Thank you very much for those beautiful, beautiful words. I wanted to share with you, I was remembering Joshin Roshi's first angle with Maizumi Roshi in 1992. He did a 3-month intensive training period. And, you know, we had been married like 4 years, but still I missed him tremendously, you know, three months away. But I was going to the last session, but still. So I was, I think, a little bit angry at Maizumi Roshi because, you know, Joshin is gone for 3 months. So I wrote Maizumi Roshi a letter and I said, yes, we can have a Zen center here. That's okay with me, but it has to have hula in it. and then I went to Sishin and, you know, I kind of forgot about the letter. And, you know, anyway, it was quite something to be in Sishin with Maizumi Roshi and a full Zendo up there. And when I got home and when Joshin Roshi came home, he had a present for me from Maizumi Roshi. And this is what Maizumi Roshi gave me, this beautiful Buddha. And I thought, oh, I think that must mean yes, we can have hula and Zen together. So my path is really entwined with this hula, which is a cultural, spiritual dance of the Hawaiian people. And it is all about respect, love. Aloha means deep love for yourself, for the environment around you. And for me, hula brings such a rich diversity to Zen, to our Zen here. And I'm so happy so many of my hula students are here tonight to dance this fabulous dance. So I must say also, I am indebted to our Roshi Bernie Glassman and Eve Marco and Jishu for the Zen Peacemaker community. They were instrumental in working with fear, the Auschwitz bearing witness retreats, homeless street retreats. And I think today, you know, we've been training all these years, as Eve told me, Joan Halifax Roshi told her, we have trained all of our lives for this time. So I'm grateful for the peacemakers and the Zen peacemaker community. And I am also very grateful for my husband. You know, it's really what a dance it is with my partner of 32 years, right? There are good times, there are bad times, but I remember one piece of advice I was given just before I left Portland, Oregon, from working in the food bank there, feeding people. A woman told me it's important for a relationship to take separate vacations. And number two is fight fair. So I think that is two very wise things that I've tried to incorporate in my life. So for me, the Zen Center has been a very natural thing to do, because meditation helps me tremendously. So why not have a place to share that with others? And I'm grateful for the Sangha. That was so amazing, that video. Christian worked so hard on that. Everybody put their hearts into that. That is what has grown our place, the Sangha community. All of us working together as we each have our different gifts, and it takes all of us to build a community. So I think with that, I'd like to introduce this man, my husband. Yay!
Yeah, sit down. Yeah, so, where to begin, where to end? Well, I think people are the most important, and the Sangha is, at the end of the day, love is what matters, and it's not that complicated. And I have many good friends in my life because of this practice. And I have many sanghas in my life. This sangha, the Peacemaker Community, Jikyo Roshi's sangha, Zen Center Los Angeles. I have many good friends in my life because of this. And the best friend I have, of course, is my wife, I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for her. And we've been married over 30 years, and we have been working together to create this kind of a center from the very beginning. And then the other thing I want to say is that I had many good teachers. I've been very fortunate to have many good mentors in my life. But the last one I had was Jikyo Roshi, and the teacher that gave me transmission. And there's one thing that Roshi taught me, imparted to me, that stuck, and that was to trust the Dharma no matter what. So you can't destroy the Dharma, you can't gain it, you can't possess it. You can just trust the Dharma. If you're going to trust something, trust the Dharma. And she taught me that. So when I had Inca, I think it was, I don't know, about 10 years after my transmission, which is in Zen, is sort of the final seal of approval from your teacher. She gave me Inca. And I felt then, as a lineage holder in the White Plum, that I had some responsibility to the tradition I was receiving in the lineage, and which I value greatly. And we were practicing. Most of our lives, we've been practicing in a very traditional way, as Pam described it in Hawaii. I was pretty strict, and we wore robes, and you had to make the zafu just the right way on the zabuton, and it was just crazy. But that's the way I trained, and I actually loved that practice. I learned it from my Izumi Roshi. It was very strict and very rigorous, and very useful way to practice. But by the time I had Inca with Jikyo Roshi, I felt like we had been practicing in Chicago, and we had been practicing in this traditional way, and it wasn't working. there's something about the Zen tradition that I think is really actually quite unique. And that is that the Zen is really fearless about deconstructing the self and deconstructing reality, and even deconstructing itself. You know, we have the saying, if you meet the Buddha on the road, kill him. I mean, what religion says to kill the founder of the religion? And so there's this something about Zen that I got over the years about deconstruct, and I also got it through being an artist. So I started it, once I had Inca, I started, before I ever created any mindfulness curriculum, I just going by the seat of my pants. I didn't know what I was doing half the time. It was pretty intuitive, but I felt like I had to take things apart. And I did. I started taking everything apart. And at one point I took the Buddha off the altar and put a lava rock on there. And I had a really good senior student who was almost ready to have transmission from me. And she left. She was really pissed off at me. So I did things to excess, and at times I was arrogant, but I deconstructed the practice, and I was able to do that because I had learned to trust the Dharma. I wasn't doing all this consciously. I can see it on hindsight when I reflect back on it. But I took a lot of things out, a lot of the ritual, because I wanted the tradition to be alive, and it just felt like it was dying, and it was kind of dead and rigid and stale, and I wanted to find the spirit of the tradition, and I didn't know what it was, but I had some faith that if I took everything away, then what mattered would come back, or it would, and that's what's happened, actually. And it's a, I didn't do this. We've all done this, and what has come back is who we are today. And I think what has come back is a more lively way of honoring what we have received from all our ancestors who we stand on the shoulders of. But instead of it then starting to become like a museum, we've actually started to bring that tradition alive in our time, in this place. And I know we will continue to do this because we have an incredible, wonderful sangha now, really strong practitioners. And I'm just so grateful to all of you to just have the opportunity to practice with you in this way and to build this kind of Zen center that will be able to serve future generations, as Eve said. Really what matters at this point, when you're my age, what matters is we want this to keep going, and we want it to serve younger generations, and we want it to be in service to healing the planet and healing all the injustice and suffering in our community as best we can, and create new upayas, new ways of bringing the wisdom the wisdom doesn't change, the Dharma doesn't change, but we find new ways of bringing it to life in the times that we're in. Okay, I was told I wasn't gonna talk too long, and I said if I talked too long that June could interrupt me and stop me, so I'm gonna stop.
That's good.
That was great. Thank you. I'm so proud to be a member of this sangha myself. So it was wonderful. I'd like to recognize Christian Solarzano. He's brought a special energy and set of skills to ZLMC. He's a new member of our board of directors. He's a visual designer. He's been creating the social media posts promoting the 10th anniversary. He's a fan of all things cinema, writing, art, music, photography. He's got a toast for us. So Christian.
Hey everyone, could you guys hear me? Cool. So I came to the center, I believe it was late 2018, I had a meditation practice prior to coming here, but I felt like I needed to strengthen my practice by learning from someone that had a rich tradition and a lineage. So I took my first class, I believe it was late 2018. And since then I've made wonderful friends. I've established a wonderful sense of community here. I really like everyone here, and I'm super thankful for Sensei and Roshi. They know, but they teach me so much unknowingly as well. My life has enhanced because of the things that I've learned here, not just in my personal life, but also in my work life. And since then I've been privileged enough to be helping the center enhance their communications and just helping out where I can, because I do truly believe that what everyone is doing here is really, really special and is truly making a difference in the world. So with that said, I would like to raise a glass and say a toast. Thank you so much to everyone. Thank you, Sensei. Thank you, Roshi. And thank you, everyone else, for making this such a special place.
Okay, so now it is time for a little dancing. And I have my Saturday little girls that are growing up going to be dancing. So if you put it on gallery view, and then if you stop your video, all the girls who are here, are you here, girls? Mute your, turn off your videos, and they will all come together, the dancing girls. Okay, are they still awake? Where are those girls? All right, where are they? Ah, there's Nova, great. And there is Kama, and there's Evie and Alice. And where is Tamia? Tamia?
Yeah, another window.
Okay, Tamia. Yeah. All right, yes. Let's see here. Okay, so turn off your videos, everybody. Stop your videos and they will all come up together. So Anna, turn off your video. And where is Kama and where did they go? Oh, you know, we've been having a little bit of difficulties here. Where is Kama, Chloe? I know that some, you know, with the internet, it's hard to know whether you're going to get it. But Nova, where are you? Nova, Nova. Okay, well, they're not here.
They're all there, June.
Oh, you see them? Okay, I don't see them. Okay, well, then I'm going to start the music, all right? Are you ready, girls? Okay, here you go. This song is by Celine Dion from Beauty and the Beast. How does a moment last forever?
How does a moment last forever? How can a story never die? It is love we must hold on to. Never easy, but we try. Sometimes our happiness is captured. Somehow a time and place stand still. Love lives on inside our hearts and always will. Minutes turn to hours, days to years and through. But when all else has been forgotten, still our song lives on. Maybe some moments aren't so perfect, maybe some memories not so sweet, but we have to know some fact, or our lives are incomplete. And when the shadows overtake us, just when we feel all hope is gone, we'll hear a song in no one's mouth, a lovely song. How does our happiness endure through the darkest of our troubles? Love is beauty, love is pure. Love frees the mind to desolation. It flows like a river through the soul, protects, precedes, and perseveres, and makes us worth. Hours, days to years that go. When all else has been forgotten, still our soul lives on. How does a moment last forever when our soul lives?
Very nice, girl. Very nice. Thank you.
Really fantastic. Thanks. Superb. Just to note, just since Roshi and Sensei spoke, we've had $2,775 come in. So with the match and the previous donations, I think we're pushing pretty hard to the goal. So we really appreciate the donations. Thanks. I'd like to introduce Shu-Ping Tsang now for a special toast. She's a dedicated supporter of the center. She also dances for the Halau I Ka Pono hula group for our hula dancers. She was born and grew up in Taiwan, used to be a nurse. She's planning to go back to that work again. She's the wife of Dr. Nima Motagi, who's an Iranian Australian, mother of an 11-year-old son, Shervin, all of whom began their family life in Oak Park a little more than 6 years ago. She's a kind person, nature lover, spirit seeker. We love her. Welcome, Shu-Ping.
Thank you. Can you hear me? Thank you. And first, I want to say happy 10th anniversary to our Zen Life and Meditation Center and also Hula School. Actually, in 2014, I believe that's the time, I got invited by a very good friend. Her name is Nicole Sumida and her family to join one of a hula event as a guest that day. And from that time, I had a very strong connection. I don't know, somehow I felt it from my heart. Then I started to take the hula lessons and the meditation prime service as well. Sorry, I still so in touch with Jun and Roshi's talk. Okay, so Zen Life and Meditation Center, it's just like a harbor and a lighthouse to me. The open arm, like a mother's heart, that provides supportive love and warmth when I face the life challenges. The primary series opened the gate of mindfulness and the Zen life practice for me. And a commit to sit, I believe now it's in our 173 days now, has kept me grounded and more aware of my life journey. Moreover, the wisdom and the lessons I have learned from Sunday morning Zen are really nourishing and cultivating me. I'm growing and growing step by step, day by day. And I also want to mention, as Kumu Jun's hula student, what I learned first lesson and still very helpful in my life is be gentle to yourself. Be gentle to yourself. If you don't learn something now, it's okay. Keep practice. Keep practicing. Eventually, it will come. Body and mind connection takes time. And that's it. So should I do this too? Cheers. Thank you for wonderful people and of course for our sensei and the Roshi. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you very much, Shu-Ping. All right, I appreciate that, thank you. So now we're gonna have one more dance. I know we're going a little over time, we're so sorry, but it's there's a lot to say for 10 years. So all my hula students now are going to be dancing this wonderful song. So I would ask everyone to stop your videos and everyone and go to the gallery view and all the hula students will come together. They should. And we have songwriters of this song, my dear friends, dear.
We're here. Yes,
I love this song, what you did with this song. So I loved it so much. I taught it to all of my students that were dancing it tonight. And for me, just, you know, in spite of greed and anger and craziness, you know, you can kind of break away, right? That's our practice, meditation. We can kind of change and get grounded in our body. And another wonderful message of this song is, you know, time is passing. And that's for sure, that's nature's way. And so here we are. I hope you like it. I'm also going to dance and I'm going to mirror. This is how I teach the class. I mirror. So I'll be going a different way from everybody, but they'll be seeing me. Okay.
Inside out like you today. Greedy minds play their foolish mind games. Nature of the sun, if a buyer came, well, I heard you say it's a brand new day. Can't hold us down if we break away. Come on, sisters and brothers, let's kiss the sky. Lift one another, let's just try. The earth, there's no need to cry, because I heard you say it's a brand new day. Can't hold us down if we break away. Thank you. sweetly rising to open our eyes. Let's connect our hearts, let's kiss the sky. Join in to say it's a brand new day. Can't hold back time. It's nature's way.
Awesome.
That was lovely.
Mahalo, mahalo.
There's Kyoki.
Beautiful choreography. Mahalo, John.
And the years.
And while that was going on, we went over $3,000. So here's to it.
Cheers.
Just doing that. Awesome.
One more toast tonight. I want to bring to the center stage tonight Mark Shishin Galula. He's the immediate past president of our board of directors, retired professor at UIC College of Medicine, where he taught mindfulness meditation to medical students. He has a passion for volunteer work with hospice, and he leads workshops in the GRACE program at ZLMC, which I've been through. It's a great program. So Mark, could you make a toast?
Can you all hear me?
Yes.
Great. Okay. Wow. 10 years. Fantastic. So Pat and I have been members of this wonderful Sangha for 9 years. I still remember my first time walking into 38 Lake Street, early one very, very cold wintry morning. The place was quiet, maybe a half a dozen people sitting Zazen. And now every morning there are 20 or more sitting Zazen virtually. Shikan has done a wonderful job with Commit to Sit, and I'm so happy to be a part of that. The intimacy at that time struck me, and it still strikes me every morning. How many times have Pat and I entered that place on 46 Lake now? I've lost count. But what I've not lost is the value of the Zen Life and Meditation Center. The value is spoken of through this glorious event this evening. And we see and feel the beauty of our Sangha in everybody's toasts and all the joy, and it's just fabulous. I was thinking as I was getting ready for this about two chapters in the Lotus Sutra. As I was thinking about them and my appreciation for Roshi and Sensei, with whom ZLMC wouldn't be possible. I want to tell you that about what I thought about. Chapter 20 tells the story of the Bodhisattva, never disrespectful. I love that name. Who serves as a model of the Bodhisattva way. Despite various problems over the eons, he never lost hope that people would become Buddhas in the future through practicing the Bodhisattva way. He trusted all because of their Buddha nature. Many times over these 9 years, I've seen and felt this belief in each of us as Buddhas from Roshi and Sensei. Now to continue with this little riff, we see in chapter 15 of the Lotus Sutra, hosts of bodhisattvas who suddenly well out of the earth, great image. They're entrusted with truth and encouraged to put that truth into practice in the future. That future is now for us at ZLMC. Roshi and Sensei are such bodhisattvas. The truth that they have put into practice is the wisdom that has created our Sangha. Roshi and Sensei have emerged as true leaders and teachers of the Dharma, supporting our Sangha as it grew and as it is now flourishing. Roshi and Sensei, I give you my thanks and admiration and ask that all of you here join me tonight one last time as we lift our glasses to them once again with great love and thanks.
Terrific, thanks, Shishin. And now to end the evening on a really high-spirited note, we have a really special presentation starring Moshe Cohen as Mr. Yuhu in a short film by Peter Cunningham. Moshe and Peter are with us tonight. Can you give a wave and let everybody know who you are?
Where is he?
Where you are? Give a hi.
Moshe, where are you? Hi there, I'm here.
Yes.
Let's do it. Super. There's a lot of toast going on. I gotta say, you really know how to celebrate. Wait, I don't have any.
You have to get more.
This bra.
Oh, okay. Well,
that's Moshe. He creates, performs, and teaches in the world of the funny. For 40 years, he sought to bring more lightness and laughter to the world as a teacher, performer, and actor. He started teaching Clowning Your Zen workshops. I love that. with Roshi Bernie Glassman. Shifting his focus from performance to lightening up, creating mindful collaborative communication and enhancing personal well-being. He studied in clown with Richard Pochinko, Tibor Turba, and Wavy Gravy, who I've seen. In movement with Sigfrido Aguilar, Daniel Stein School, and the Antwerp and Mind Studio. In Japanese Kyogen with Kaoru Matsumoto and Juro Zenchu, and in Butoh dance with Kazuo Ono in Japan and with the Tominos in California. Peter's been a professional photographer for more than 30 years. His teachers include Baptist fisherman Lester Tate, dancer Martha Myers, French photographer Henri Cartier-Bresson, Zen master Bernie Glassman, singer-songwriter Janice Ian. He's exhibited his photographs and still films in New York, Krakow, London, Paris, Tokyo, Jerusalem, Kigali, Nanjing, Beijing, Berlin, and Grand Maman, Canada. His clients include singers, teachers, chefs, playwrights, athletes, accountants, actors, fishermen, and clowns. He teaches photography as Zen practice in the US and China. He's a co-author with Peter Matthiessen of Are We There Yet? A Zen Journey Through Space and Time. And he's a founding member of the Order of Disorder. So ladies and gentlemen, we present This Land Is Your Land.
This land is your land. This land is my land. From California to the New York Island. From the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream water. You know this land was made for you and me. The sign it said private property.
I'm gonna do a closing dedication and dedicate the merits of this gathering tonight to rededicate the merits of our practice together and our this meeting tonight to all the Buddhas and Bodhisattvas throughout all space and time, to the three treasures of the Buddha, the Dharma, and the Sangha, to all the teachers in our lineage, and to the women whose names are unspoken, unsaid, to all the members of our Sangha locally and our greater Sangha, to your ancestors, to your family, to all those who are disenfranchised, whose voices are unheard, to all those who are lonely, who are afraid, to those who are dying without alone, to those families who have lost loved ones. And may we go forward with joy in our hearts, that we have the love of each other and the love of the Dharma, which will sustain us through all these dark times and carry us forward with resilience and strength and love.
And that concludes our program. Thanks for everybody for coming, your support, your love tonight, and through the first 10 years of our center. We'll hold the Zoom open as people depart. If anybody wants to say hello to each other, give a last toast, you're more than welcome to. And we hope we'll be able to see you a year from tonight in person at the Zen Center. So good night, carry on here for a little longer if you wish. And thanks so much for coming. It was great to have you.
Thank you, Robert.
Thank you, Robert.
Thank you, Robert.
Thank you, Roshi and Sensei.
Wait. Let me close the chat.
Thank you, Robert.
Thank you.
Thank you, Shiki.
Thank you,
Robert.
Thank you.
Bye.
Wendy, thank you very much for your help, Wendy.
Earl, where are you, Earl? Go Bears.
Is Earl here?
Earl.
Go Bears.
Bye.
Good job, Lauren. Nice job dancing, everybody.
Beautiful.
Nick, where are you?
Oh, it's so lovely to see you again. Oh, I love you.
It was beautiful dancing, and we love you folks. Stay warm in Chicago.
Aloha.
Thank you, Kaoki and Yvonne. That Thank beautiful you. Song. Love it. Thank you,
Lauren, for that beautiful.
It was nice to see you folks do it.
I couldn't hear you, Joshin. What was that?
I was thanking Lauren for her, for the beautiful.
Oh, okay. Love you. Aloha.
Love you. Yvonne, take care now. Both of you too.
Bye all.
Shu-Ping, love you.
Yeah. Mahalo for June. Aloha. Mahalo from Michigan.
Robert, way to go.
Nancy and Marion, nice to see you.
Thank you. Deep, deep aloha. Nani Kei, it was beautiful.
Oh, good. Mahalo nui.
Thank you for
Robert and Vivian.
Me.
Nice to see you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I see. Ahoy ho.
Ahoy ho. Ahoy ho. Aloha. Risha.
In a few minutes. Ahoy ho.
Ahoy ho.
Aloha.
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 Gwen.
need it.
Gwen.
Right.
Aloha. Thank you for a beautiful evening. It's been wonderful. Happy to help you celebrate the 10th anniversary of the Zen Meditation Center. It's been great. Thank you so very much. It's been beautiful.
It takes a village.
Yeah. Okay.
We're going to start commit to sit at 4 a.m. tomorrow, so.
Go at that, Michael. Have fun.
Mary Rose, nice to see you, Mary Rose.
Is David going to wake you at 4 in the morning for that?
Probably for everybody sharing it.
Mary Rose, you can unmute yourself. There's a mute button.
Shu-Ping, it was lovely to see you dancing.
Yay! Thank you, June. Yeah, for teaching. Even I'm in Wisconsin now, I still be able to attend the class.
That's great.
Yeah. And the same, thank you, Michael. You keep me awake in the morning.
In June, it was beautiful. I enjoyed every minute of it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good night.
I'll be sending something into the Zen Center.
Thank you, Mary Rose. Thank you.
Good night, everybody.
Good night, everybody. Good
night. Ooh. Yeah. That was fun. All right.
Robert, we never got to see you stand up and take a bow.
Nice job,
Robert. Nice job, Robert. You're so handsome.
I have on my very best sweatpants.
Sweatpants.
He's got the pants on.
Sweatpants.
I got out my best pair of sweatpants for this.
Looks
<You're> washed.
Oh, you shouldn't have shown us.
Oh, that's if you hang around to the last seven people, that's what you get. It's my sweatpants.